3.14159265389795? Whatever, start the episode.
Restate my assumptions. 1. Mathematics is the language of nature. 2. Everything around us can be represented and understood through numbers. 3. If you graph the numbers of any system, patterns emerge.
This man, with unkempt hair and sunken eyes, is a reclusive New York mathematician named Max Cohen, and he restates these assumptions ad nauseum. And as unhinged as the character may seem, his assumptions appear reasonable. Of course math is natural, and of course everything around us can be represented by numbers. Everything, our economy, our politics, our health, depends on their reliability. Quality is subjective, but quantity? That's truth. So Max Cohen, who's closer than anyone on Earth to understanding that truth, must feel pretty secure, right? Well... And yes, I know I didn't release this video on Pi Day, but since I can't time travel to March 14th, 1592 at 6:53 and 58 seconds AM, deal with it? Pi is the debut film by Darren Aronofsky. Aronofsky's body of work sprang from this source. Max, like so many other Aronofsky characters, is in search of some form of transcendence, some great impossible feat. Something that takes them beyond human experience and into the sublime. And it always, 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 always goes badly. Oh yeah, spoilers. It's not like it's the most famous scene in the movie or anything. Pi's aesthetics owe plenty to surrealist masterpieces like Un Chien Andalou. Of course, in the mid-90s, with grunge and MTV breaking molds, early surrealists were in vogue. The movie made famous use of Snorricam, aka the universal signifier of getting plastered, plus high contrast photography, which eliminates all grays, giving it a scratchy, grainy look, which uneases. And the result of all these creative choices is that Pi is a subjective film. Everything the camera does is tied to Max, sometimes literally. We are inside Max's head. We, too, seek truth, as he seeks truth. And with his home computer, he finds truth, in the form of a 216-digit number. And others want that truth, from Wall Street to the synagogue.
The high priest had one ritual to perform in the Holy of Holies. He had to intone a single word. That word was the true name of God.
So?
The true name, which only the Kohanim knew, was 216 letters long.
So, has Max found God? 'Cause if so, God hurts. But why? If we're all supposed to be closer to God, then why would proximity to him hurt? Common religious films talk about revelation as being this great, loving force which overwhelms and uplifts. But for Aronofsky, God is pain. And yes, this is a movie less about math than it is about religion. Aronofsky's had a lifelong fascination with Abrahamic religion. It's even present in Noah, as panned as it was. But his interpretation of scripture is rather esoteric, to put it lightly. So, what does Aronofsky believe?
You ever hear of Kabbalah?
No.
Jewish mysticism.
So, a very quick rundown of esoteric Jewish theology. Judaism teaches that there was a direct connection with God that was present at creation and was lost with the expulsion from the Garden of Eden. At the Tower of Babel, we lost that connection further when God confused the language of the tower's architects. This is why Judaism, and its offshoots, stress the importance of the Holy Word. It's why at bar and bat mitzvahs, children are instructed to learn passages from the Torah in the original Hebrew, and not the vernacular. And why many observant Jews refuse to write the full name of God, to avoid taking the holy name in vain. God is present, but they are also absent. As 20th century Kabbalah scholar Gershom Scholem wrote, "Once the fear of sullying God's sublimity with earthly images becomes a paramount concern, less and less can be said of God. The price of God's purity is the loss of his living reality. To preserve the purity of the concept of God without loss of his living reality, that is the never-ending task of theology." God, in this view, isn't the old bearded man reaching down to touch Adam's finger. God is Schrodinger's cat. God is the tree falling in the forest. God is what Kant might call the noumenon, something which, by definition, one can't experience through phenomena, through the senses. God is that which cannot be proven. Because if you could prove them, then by definition, they would no longer be God. That's the frustrating thing about theism, that necessary comfortability with a lack of answers. I'm sure plenty of doubters have thrown their hands up in frustration for the umpteenth time their questions have been brushed off with, mysterious ways. I mean, yeesh. No wonder that guy put a drill to his head. Of course, you can sit back smugly and say, the answer's obvious. We can't explain God because there is no God. And that's a perfectly logical conclusion. I'm a non-believer myself. But Aronofsky doesn't like easy answers. He's taken that core theological question and reframed it as a secular question.
1245, restate my assumptions.
1 + 1 = 2. Even a child knows this. To have an ant and to add another ant will produce 2 ants. But first, don't I have to apply the value of 1 to this ant? When I could easily call it 6 legs, 3 body segments, millions of cells, billions of molecules? Shouldn't I first call the ant 1 before I can call these ants 2? Or is the oneness of the ant inherent to it? Is the two-ness of both ants inherent to them? It's a long debate in advanced mathematics. Is math created or discovered? Whether or not math is a feature of the universe or a tool created by humans in order to understand it. I'm not even close to a mathematician, so I won't embarrass myself trying to untangle that question. Here are links to better, smarter YouTubers than me talking about it, so go ahead, follow them. But even in an everyday understanding of math, we know that these 10 digits can't possibly express every quantity we know to exist. It's why we have the concepts of infinity, why we have variables, why we have a special symbol for the impossible but useful square root of -1, and why we used this innocuous Greek letter to represent a ratio we can't express in a finite amount of digits, just because our system of quantification won't allow it. But still, we know math works simply because it works. For example, Darren Aronofsky famously made this movie on a micro-budget of about $60,000. He got that money by crowdsourcing individual $100 donations from friends and family. So that would be from 600 or so investors. He promised these investors that he would pay them back $150 if the movie made money. So in order to pay his investors back, he would have to have made at least $90,000, which he did. According to Box Office Mojo, he made $3.2 million, and his investors were probably very happy. Restate our assumptions. 60,000 divided by 100 equals 600. 600 times 150 equals 90,000. 90,000 greater than 60,000. 1 + 1 = 2. And we know these to be true without ever having to interrogate the idea of 100, 1,000, multiplication, division, math. We just know that it's true because it is true. The idea that there's an order to the universe that will keep its order regardless of whether or not we are there to see it? Isn't that faith?
Even though we're not sophisticated enough to be aware of it, there is a pattern, an order. Maybe that pattern is like the pattern in the stock market, the Torah, this 216 number.
This is insanity, Max.
Or maybe it's genius.
With Pi, Aronofsky's proven the true place of theistic wisdom in an atheistic world, revitalizing religion with some of its mystery, and revealing its true purpose. Because the big questions, the ones that really matter to human life, are never as simple as, is there a God, or where do we come from, or why is this happening? Those are simple questions, with logical, if unfulfilling, answers. Maybe there's a better question. And that better question might be the only one worth knowing. What does it mean to know? What do we gain by knowing? Will we know when we know? Given the limitations of experience, is knowing even a possibility? Will we never know? How do we know if we'll never know? No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Yeah, I know. 3.14159265358979323846264338327950288419715105.